Hi guys, I'm Eileen. So last week, I posted a video about the best luxury brands to buy on sale. So I thought this week, I will share with you the healthy ways to do your shopping during sales season. Now I'm sure during this time of the year, you will see a lot of luxury hauls and unboxing videos. So it can be hard to not be tempted into buying something that you don't need. In the past, I was certainly guilty of that as well, but in the last few years, I've come to realize that it's completely possible to enjoy sales very intentionally. In fact, if you embrace the very mindful shopping mindset, Black Friday and Boxing Day can be the perfect time to enjoy some savings on your wishlist items. So today, I want to share with you some of the very common shopping behaviors during sale period and why you should avoid them. First of all, don't buy something that you didn't know you wanted before the sale. In fact, sometimes you might not even know the item existed until it made an appearance on the sales section. Essentially, don't buy something just because it's discounted. Strictly speaking, if something used to cost £100 and is now being discounted at 40% off, we are still spending £60, not saving £40. So it's really important to not let the sales and the offers distract you. I think that's a good reason why people buy so much at outlet stores, because we are constantly being reminded that outlet prices are cheaper than retail prices, and that creates a sense of urgency because it's too good a deal to pass on. So I would suggest to forget about the sale percentage because it is just a decoy. So if something is now £50 instead of £200, ask yourself, is this item worth your £50? If not, you know you can move on. Along the same line, try to only buy the things you would happily pay full price for. I always recommend everyone to have a wish list, because if something already caught your attention at full price, it's a pretty good sign that you like it a lot, so a good sale only helps to close the deal. I think you'll also find that having a wish list really helps to save time because you're not browsing the sales section aimlessly. Quite simply, if your wishlist item is discounted, you can think about buying it, otherwise look no further. This way, you will be sure you are only buying the things you really love, but at cheaper prices. Next, if you don't have anything on your wishlist, be okay with it. In fact, be happy with it. I think sometimes seeing how everyone is rushing to get the best deals can make you feel like you are not doing it right if you don't join the crowd. In the past, I would watch a lot of unboxing videos, and they often make me feel like I was missing out if I didn't at least get something on sale. But now I'm older, my perspective changed quite a bit. I mean, sales can be great and shopping can be fun, but Christmas and Thanksgiving are supposed to be about family, so it's really a wonderful thing when you prioritize your time and energy for your loved ones instead. Next, I will also recommend setting a budget for your Black Friday shopping and try your very best to not exceed the limit. At first, it might require a bit of self-discipline, but practice makes perfect. Honestly, you are not depriving yourself, but rather you are respecting your budget, and that is really one of the best things we could do for ourselves. I've always said that shopping expenses should be at the bottom of everyone's financial spreadsheet, and it's really important to take care of other responsibilities first. For example, paying your bills, saving for retirement, and investing for your future. The rest of the money is your fun money, which means you can now shop without any guilt. I think when you picture it like that, setting a budget can feel really empowering rather than restricting. Besides, when you put a cap on how much you can spend, you will naturally prioritize what you buy, which means you will only buy what you absolutely love. So when you think about it, it's really a win-win situation. Another major shopping mistake to avoid, especially during sale season, is settling for less. If your wishlist item happens to be in very high demand, it might sell out very quickly in the color and the size you want. Now, I completely understand it can be very disappointing to miss out on a good deal, but just remember the item is only worth your money if it's perfect for you. In the past, I would be very tempted to compromise and just buy whatever that's left. For example, the shoes in my size were sold out, and I would then contemplate if I should buy the next size up because I could just improve the fit with a pair of insoles. Or I might really want a jumper in a black color, and I started convincing myself dark blue should do the job as well. My experience tells me that if you have to talk yourself into buying something, it really means it's not a good fit for you or your wardrobe. Therefore, even if the item is discounted at 90% off, it's really still a waste of money. Personally, I would much rather pay full price for something that I really enjoy rather than paying half price for something I don't reach for. Another shopping mistake to avoid, especially during sale season, is buying more than you need. I feel like this is especially relevant for skincare and makeup products because during this time of the year, you will see a lot of amazing offers like 3 for 2 or buy one and get the next one for half price. Even though this might work out to be very good deals, it's important to be mindful with how much you buy. I'm sure you know skincare and makeup products have an expiry date and a lot of them only last for 12 months. So if you only need 2 bottles of serum a year, it's quite pointless to buy 6 even if it works out cheaper that way. I feel like one of the worst things we could do with our money is throwing away unused products due to poor planning. On that note, make sure to also not fall for the free gift and free delivery trap. I'm sure you've noticed when you shop online, a lot of retailers are always encouraging you to buy more. For example, at checkout, they might prompt you to spend another £40 to qualify for a free gift, which might just be a cosmetic bag with some sample size products. I highly recommend you to resist the temptation to top up the difference because chances are you are wasting money on something that you don't need to get a free gift that you might never use. Next one is a shopping behavior that might be a bit more common during sale period, and that is buying in excess because you know you can return them. Now obviously, online shopping is amazing nowadays, and we can pretty much order and return anything without too much effort. In fact, a lot of luxury items come with complimentary free shipping and return. In a way, I think that's encouraging mindless shopping because we, the consumers, are not being penalized if a return is needed. Obviously, this is all part of the service, but I feel like it's crucial we all shop a bit more responsibly and not add to the carbon footprint unnecessarily. If you're not too sure about an item, it's probably best not to buy it. Also, make sure to do plenty of research about colors and sizes for any item you might be interested in, because that will help to reduce a lot of exchanges and returns. Personally, I find returning an item a hassle, so that in a way has helped to limit my online shopping or just shopping in general. During this festive season, some people might receive vouchers and gift cards. So I want to briefly talk about how to spend these generous blessings wisely. A while ago, I've read a book called Predictably Irrational by Dan Ariely, and the author suggested that a lot of people tend to see vouchers, gift cards, unexpected bonus, and tax rebates as free money. This then leads to mindless spending. For example, you might receive a gift card, which you then decided to spend on a luxurious candle. But that might be something you would have never bought, especially not with the money you earn from working a job or running a business. In reality though, tax rebates, vouchers, and gift cards are real money, and so they really should be valued and consumed in the same way. So what I'm saying is, don't rush to a store and desperately try to use up the voucher. I personally like to spend my gift cards on essential items now, or things I would normally buy anyway. So for example, groceries, toiletries, and undergarments. It might sound quite uninteresting, but I think that is a much better use for a well-meaning gift. On a bigger scale, if you're fortunate enough to receive your year-end bonus, Remember that you've worked for it and it's not free money. In fact, I would even recommend investing or putting away that money straight away as if you've never received it. That way, you will not have the urge to start making random impulse purchases. There you have it. Those are the shopping mistakes or behaviors I think everyone should avoid, especially during sales season. Now, I think shopping can be a very nice way to treat ourselves, especially when you've worked hard for the entire year. Besides, buying on sale can be a fantastic way to save money on your wishlist items. So I'm not anti Black Friday or Boxing Day, but I do think we could all be a bit more intentional and shop more responsibly. More importantly, this really is the time of the year to slow down, rest, reflect and spend time with our loved ones. And so when you're not completely engrossed in looking for the best deals, you have more time for the more important things in life. So that's it from me. I hope you've enjoyed the video. Thank you so much for watching and don't forget to share, like and subscribe. I will see you in my next one. Have a nice day.